The next thing which we are going to do is the subtotal feature. Now, what is a subtotal feature? Basically, if you want subtotals in pencil, suppose I want item wise, total amount of pencil sold, total amount of pen sold. So in that way, I need the subtotals. Then we use the subtotal feature, which we have also seen when we were doing pivot tables. This can also be done using pivot tables as well. So if you are not wanting to use pivot table, it can simply be done using the subtotal feature. Now, before you go into subtotal, you always need to sort your data. So I need to, and it depends according to what you sort, you want to sort your data. So let us do the sorting according to the region. Let us do it according to the region. So I'll just sort maybe A to Z. So now I have sorted my data according to the regions. I have three regions over here: Central, East, and the West. So I have sorted my data according to the region wise. Now the next thing is to go to the data tab. In the data tab, we have something over here as subtotal in the outline group. So I'll just click on this subtotal. I get this dialog box. Now this dialog box gives a number of questions at each change in. So according to what you need the subtotals, according to the rep names or the items or the region. Obviously you can't get the subtotal on the basis of the total section over here. So I'll just select region for the time being. Region has been selected. And what do you want? Do you want the sum of the central total sum of the central, west and east? Or do you want the count? Or so all those functions, average, maximum, minimum, product, so all these functions. So I'll just consider it to be a sum for the time being. And to which column you need to do the subtotal in? Obviously the subtotal can't be done for these three, so you need to do the subtotal for the total column. Replace the current subtotals. So if you have any current subtotals already done there, so you'll just replace that. This is the default thing which you have. Page breaks between groups. Now what do I mean by page breaks is that, I'll just explain after this once we do the basic one, is that after each subtotal the page will be broken. So that is, and summary below the data. So I'll explain that also. I'll just click on OK. And you can see we have the entire summary now. So for the central, you can see the central total is over here. Then we have all the east, and the east total is over here. Then we have the west and the grand total. So this is how you get all your summaries. Now instead of maybe the sum, you can get it for count. So you can change it to count, and maybe it will count all the central, how many sales have been made to the, in the central region, and you'll get the total over here. Similarly for west, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you'll get a count of 6 over here. It depends on you on what basis you need to calculate, you need the sum subtotals, right? Then you can see over here something has been added, 1, 2 and 3. So why is this so? Suppose I just want the, you just want your manager to see the subtotals. The manager is not interested in the data which is inside the subtotal. So you can just, what you can do is you can click on this minus sign which you have over here. So it will just take on, and see, it will just take on the subtotals. Or you could have just clicked on the two and it, you would have got the same. 3 is the extended. So 1, 2 and 3, the 1 will give you the grand total, 2 gives you the subtotals, and 3 will give you all entire data. So 3 will give you the entire data, 2 just gives you the subtotals and the grand total, 1 will only give you the grand total. So this is how it works, and you have all your data summarized over here. Now I can do the same thing. I can do the same thing if I want for maybe, let's suppose I want to do it item wise. So again, I'll go to the subtotal section over here. I'll just remove it all for the time being. I need to again sort my data first. So you need to sort your data first on the basis of the item, and then only you can move ahead. So A to Z. So it sorted my data according to the item. As you can see, it sorted my data according to the item. I have the binder first, then the desk, pen, pen set, pencil. So this is how it has sorted my data, data tab, subtotal, on the basis of items. And now let's suppose I want the count and the total. Now let us also try to insert the page break, and also let us remove this option of summary below data. Now what do I mean by this is that I got all the values, then I got the total for central, all the values, total value for the east. But now the value will appear on the top, the subtotal value will appear on the top, and then you'll get the data because summary below the data has been unticked. So I'll click on OK. And now you can see, first you have the grand count, because now I just unticked that summary on below option. So you are getting the summary on top. So the grand total is on the top. Then you have the binder count. So this is the binder count. Now this is the desk count, and then the values are beneath it. Pen count, pen set count, and pencil count. So this is how it works if you untick the summary below data. Also, you can see after each set, like after binder you have a page break, after desk you have a page break, after. Now these page breaks are basically if you want to take out the printout of the separate pages, like you want one page you want all the binders, in one page you want all the desk items, pen count, and so on. So this is why you do this, use this page break. For now, for the time being, we don't want this page break. So if I click again, if I click on this option 2, I just get the basic subtotals and also the grand total. If I click on 1, I just get the grand count. So this is how you work out with the subtotal feature. And these were the options which we saw. Replace current subtotals means if you have any current subtotals, so it will replace that. So it doesn't matter because initially we didn't have any. Also, page break means you can break the page between the groups, which is helpful for your printing out the data. And summary below data means that it will be below the data. Like first you have all the binder items, then you have the binder count, total binder count. If you untick this, it will be on the shown on the top. So for the time being, I'll just remove all my subtotals from here. So this is how you work out with the subtotal feature. I have written the summary in my PPT.